quit moving around. You've been walking everywhere for like 10 minutes. Look at the red light. It's on.
Okay. It is on.
Uh-oh, Bob, that means they've caught us again. Good morning, everybody. We're coming to you live from inside the main build facility here at Bubba's Exotic Motorsports. I'm Tom, and man, I'm happy to be with you guys after 2 days of being gone. We all know the master, Bubba. Good morning, Bub. How you doing today?
Doing good, man. How you doing so far? Clearly pretty freaking good. Man, you haven't sat still at all.
I haven't. And you know what? I'm as ADD as they come.
I don't think that's what ADD is. That was like a different problem.
That's Tourette's, isn't it?
No, that's when you shout random things. You have that, but that was another one. No, can't. Come on.
That's happened before, ladies and gentlemen, in the bars and everything. I am really happy to be back with you guys. I was on the road for 2 days up in the Northeast while Bob held it down here. We had an event.
I got a lot of work done, too.
You did.
You guys got nothing done.
Nothing you did went out the door. We'll talk about that a little bit later on. However, we're just going to keep on moving here. Ladies and gentlemen, here we have a nice example from one of our clients who just took possession of this beautiful 68 C10 from Barrett-Jackson that was just held here in the Palm Beaches.
Yes.
Bub, tell us a little bit about this vehicle.
Yeah, man, so this is, you already gave the intro.
Hold it, Bub. The monkeys are here, everybody. Have you seen they're crawling across the frame rail of this Chevrolet truck here? And this Chevrolet truck right here, ladies and gentlemen, Monkey in Paradise is live on the set with us, the Social Vodka. What's your paradise, Bub?
Okay, let's move past the what's your paradise thing, because I still don't get it. Number one.
Did you see, Bub? I'd like
to get back to going into what I'm dealing with here.
Wait, did you see that the monkeys made an appearance from Fenway Park?
I did, from Paul Wahlberg, which is Mark Wahlberg, the world famous actor. I think he's literally Hollywood's best male actor, really. Like,
he really
can't go wrong. Everything from rap, Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch, right?
Right.
That had to be 80s.
Marky Mark, we know you're out there watching too, brother.
Early 90s, maybe?
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. So, Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch. So, we went from rap to movies to doing just stand-up stuff. I mean, he has literally held down every arena. His brother, Paul, opened a restaurant called Wahlburgers.
Mm-hmm.
So, now that is like the Northeast best burger. And that is where the monkeys were literally last night.
Wow, man, that's pretty incredible.
Pretty good.
The monkeys have taken over. You can get your four free monkeys by writing to us at sales@bubbasexoticmotorsports.com. It's gone viral, Bub. We will send you a complimentary four-pack of monkeys from Monkey in Paradise. You are holding a contest through the 30th of April. When you get your monkey, go to Instagram or send it to us and we'll post it. Hashtag show us your monkey. And the best, most creative placement of your monkey wins a Monkey in Paradise gift pack with a bottle of vodka and a Bubba Edition Bubba's Motorsports touring sticker as well.
Yep. It'll be a super, super cool package. The contest is already getting really tough, man. I'm telling you, there's a couple that I've seen pretty freaking creative so far, and I already, out of what I have so far, what's been submitted, I already know who's winning.
Yep.
Out of what's been submitted, there's another.
You made a choice?
Out of what's been submitted, yes. There's another 3 weeks left, and we have hundreds of people submitting these things, so it's a really good chance that somebody may take out who I'm feeling for right now. They're pretty freaking good, man. They are getting creative. We are getting them now with literally, I think, one of the best ones so far. This isn't the one I've chosen, but one of the best ones is a monkey. Literally the cocktail marker with a monkey, like in his hand. It doesn't get any better than that. I mean, come on.
Speaking of which, I was with the Robertsons showing them around the island the other day. They were down to kind of see the facility.
Yep.
I was with Jen and Bud. Man, they are just good people. They're going to be back here, ladies and gentlemen, for Cars and Coffee on the 7th. I understand our sponsor, Schumacher Chevrolet, is coming in to see this line of products. The first thing that happened at the Palm event, Bub, you had a gentleman pull up next to you and ask what was on your car. Mm-hmm. Consequently, that gentleman is one of his high-end vehicles this year now because of that product.
Yep.
So the Robertsons will be here. You can come see that product demonstrated. We'll give you the time and dates of it here live. It's an amazing product.
Yeah, and the other thing, too, is, you know, we haven't even really discussed and pinpointed yet with Bud from Robertson Racing, but he is going to be our installer for that, all of the entire nano ceramic line, as well as us here at the facility. We're all going to get certified in it. Bud already is certified in the product.
He's the only person in the United States, and he is the only distributor you can purchase it from in the United States. We were talking about putting it in Summit Racing, Jags and places like that. He said, absolutely not. His loyalty, ladies and gentlemen, is so strong, it will only come through Bubba's Exotic Motorsports, and there'll be four other distribution points or hubs, as we were discussing, throughout the United States, where you can get this amazing nanotechnology.
Yeah, and if it's something, you know, there's two lines to that product. There is the do-it-yourself line, which you guys could clearly do it, but then there's also a very high-end professional 9H, which is one of the ones that we're going to be installing here at our facility, and we're looking at branching that off in multiple other locations in the Southeast. But I'll tell you, man, we're looking at having Bud come down, do a full car and a full product segment, so that you guys out there, if you do buy these kits, whether it's through us, through Bud, anybody, any of the distributors, if you buy them, you can understand how to do that process yourself at your home. I mean, again, you're taking it at your own risk, you're doing it yourself. It is a very, you don't have to have an incredible skill set to do it, but you have to have a very thorough understanding of the instructions,
especially
follow
the
them to the T. So you want to just make sure that you do it, and we'll be out here doing a full live broadcast of the application process, the prep process, and then the finished touch, and you'll see exactly what steps you need to take. So when you're at home trying to do it, it'll be a lot of fun.
There are other nanotechnologies out there. This particular Nano USA is the only true 9H out of 12H grades in the world. It's an amazing product. I've talked with the founders of this company. I had a Skype interview on Monday as well. So we're very excited about that. When we were downtown, there was literally down on the island, a guy with a monkey on his back walking around the beaches. So it was a funny story.
That's how people roll down here.
That's
freaking,
everybody's cool.
Just live monkeys and
everybody's cool. Parrots,
iguanas, servals, which are like miniature tigers essentially. The stuff is just everywhere. It's crazy.
Yep.
So you never know when your face is going to get hashtag eaten off by
hashtag monkey on your hashtag back.
You never know.
That's right. So Bub, tell us a little bit about this. This gentleman came to you because of the quality of what you build, because he recognizes you're in the best of the best of the business, and he sought you out and said he doesn't want anybody touching his vehicle except you specifically. In fact, he's very, very particular and detail-oriented. He lives in Toronto, Canada, and bought this down here in this area at the Palm Beaches, where he has a part-time residence.
Yep.
And he specifically only wanted you to touch his new Pride and Joy. So this was lot 378, ladies and gentlemen, from Barrett-Jackson here in the Palm Beaches. And Bub, why don't you tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, absolutely. So as you can see, just sitting right here, this is a 68 Chevrolet C10. To me, this was my personal body style that I liked. I mean, I like that rounded style front end. I didn't like when they switched it up. I think it was 73 to 87, they went that square off front end. Which was like, you know, the Blazers, the K5s, the C's, the K-Trucks, all of those things. This was the body style I leaned towards. I love the lines of it. It's classic. You can add, as you can see, the right wheel and tire combo. You can set that staggered stance, and you can set the suspension down. And this has a very nice Restomod / Pro Touring setup to it. That's exactly what was done here. This was a beautiful, beautiful build. I don't know who did it. It doesn't mention the history on it. I went out and Google searched it and pulled up the Barrett-Jackson docket on it.
And one of the things that Bub does, ladies and gentlemen, he's a research fanatic. He has to know everything before he touches anything.
Yeah, so, you know, well, I mean, with anything, I mean, you want to know the history. If you have a patient come in and you're a doctor, you want to know if they have any previous conditions. Have they had any
Not if I'm a dentist, though.
That's because you don't care. You would just start drilling.
Sure, I'll correct that orthopedic problem you've got. Let me grab my drill and pick.
That would be you.
That would be
and
me.
You would take out the wrong tooth, by the way.
And I'd pull the wrong tooth.
Yeah. So, you know, I went out, I did my research, I knew what I was working with. This is a complete nut and bolt restoration, and that is huge. And for the money that this client paid for this truck, he is in really
good position. He's in very good shape, ladies and gentlemen.
Let me tell you, I mean, everybody knows, and we have a lot of clients that we've built frame-off restorations for. If you can do a nut and bolt for the number he got this truck for, which you can see it out there at Barrett-Jackson's website, this truck went across the block at $40,700. That is extremely good. For this body style, this is the desirable body style. This has everything you could possibly imagine in terms of modern electronics. It's all painless wiring. It has vintage air in it. It has custom audio in it. It has the intro custom cut wheels on it, which are all billet aluminum, high polish. The paint is beautiful. The woodwork in the bed with the stainless slats in it. Everything about this truck is exactly where it should be. So we're just really doing a final once over. This thing came straight from Barrett-Jackson, Palm Beach, 10 miles up the road to us here in Jupiter. So we're doing a full once over of this thing, and we're going to get him exactly up to that 100% standpoint where he wants to be and exactly what he's looking for and, you know, his personal vehicle mount.
And while Bubba, it has a lot of the great components, the car was put together, the shift points aren't right, the motor's very sluggish, there's a lot of things you need to go through and figure out.
Yeah.
So you've spent the morning today, you brought this in on your roll back yesterday afternoon, put it away and locked it up for the main, for the night in the main facility here, which is something we do with our clients' cars, we secure them down. And you started going through every nut and bolt of this thing, figuring out every little nuance of this truck, so that when the client comes down, he is going to have something to take out and cruise. Now, the other thing, ladies and gentlemen, this will tell you how meticulous this client is. At his Toronto residence, he has a 1990, Bub. Talk about that a little bit.
Oh, his GTA.
Which he sent me pictures of, and I need to share with you. When
I was on the road, I got him.
I haven't had a chance to
see. Okay, so this is super, super cool. If you guys, if anybody out there is, you know, fan or other builders out there, if you're watching right now, if you love the third generation Camaro Firebird, what they called F bodies, if you love that style, you're gonna love this story. This is a true 1990 Pontiac Trans Am GTA.
Yep.
That was the best model you could buy, period, from Pontiac. But this was a very limited option factory with a Corvette engine in it. It was ordered that way, it was built that way. This was not a modification. This is exactly how it should be. The car is sitting at almost 30 years old with 2,000 miles on it.
2,000 kilometers or 1,000 miles.
And that's it.
Yep.
That is it. Like, there's five digits on that speedometer. It hasn't rolled once. It's just 0-0 and then starting. Like, that is it. This thing is incredible. I mean, I can't wait to see. He's literally gonna ship this car down because it hasn't been run in 20 years. It's just been sitting in a warehouse that's all climate controlled, so it's not like a barn find. This thing is mint condition like
covered
this.
Up, ladies and gentlemen. Like, you ought to see the pictures of this thing.
Just sitting, ready to go. It's ready to hit a transport, come down, get all of its fluids changed. Gonna need tires on it for sure.
Oh, but sure.
And those things should have been on
GTA. Probably a Goodyear tire. The Goodyear Eagle tire.
Probably was on that. Yep. And those were like a
hard compound.
Hold on, wait for it. Those were you ready for this? 245 50 16.
Watch. Right on, ladies and gentlemen.
I bet if you go,
that's the kind of technology
that,
he's walking.
I bet
on.
If you Google search that, it will probably come up pretty freaking close. 245 50 16 front and rear. And they were the same fitment, 16x8s all the way around.
Yep. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. So this is a fun client. We're going to take care of that GTA. Some people gave him some bad information about firing off that motor. He wants to make sure the quality.
You just have to do your final prep, or just like anything, do your prep work to ensure that when you do take that final shot, whether it's anything you're doing, make sure it's the call you want to make. And that's it. Flush the fluids out right away. Get everything fresh.
All the brake fluid, all the fuel, everything.
Spend a couple days getting everything flush, get it all cleaned out, and then you're good to go. Before you fire it up, spin the motor over manually, get some fluid priming around in that thing. You can even pull the distributor out and run the oil pump a little bit if you really wanted to. That time would have been a hydraulic flat tap, a camshaft, and it possibly a roller depending on the motor they used. But it'll be fine.
And that's just it. That's why people send these cars to you, Bub, because this is an art form to you. It's something you care very deeply and passionately about. You feel, you eat, sleep, live this thing.
Well, it's supposed to be fun, you know, and there's too much of the drama in this world and the negativity out there where, you know, I have a lot of in this industry. I mean, my closest friends are my competition. Truly, they are. But we all hang on a level that, you know, if you can't honestly say, hey, you know what, you guys did a freaking great job building it, then you shouldn't be in the game. Like, you shouldn't. If you're out there building and you have that dick attitude about you where you just either talk trash about people or you talk bad, talk down on them, then it's never going to work. You're going to have that attitude. Just enjoy it. There's builders out there all the way across the world. You saw the truck Schumacher brought in this morning. That freaking truck was top quality, man.
That was. Ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about a dually diesel.
Yep.
Ram diesel owned by a professional golf player who just traded that truck in.
Yep.
I think they wanted $117,000 for it, and this car is done right. Go to SchumacherAuto.com and look at that vehicle on the website, that green Dodge Dually. It's an amazing vehicle. It's an amazing build. Bell may have a picture of it here. He can actually show you.
This is one of those things where, you know, if you can't just openly admit, like, whoever built that truck did some freaking hard work, there's a lot of time and money into it, you know, then if you can't compliment it, then you just shouldn't be doing it.
Yeah, I mean, if you got something negative to say, just keep your mouth shut.
I don't know, Matt, where you're zoomed at.
But that's a nicely built vehicle. That is a nicely built vehicle.
Oh, that's a lot of glare.
How about now?
That's better. There we go. Good job.
How about now? Anything?
Oh, wow, that's great.
So, you know, there's, like this, it's a nicely built vehicle.
Right, and you know, with everything, there's always something certain people are gonna wanna change. That's what makes this stuff fun. It's a hobby, it's a passion. People do this because they enjoy it. They like the color tone, they like the wheels, they like the stainless trim that comes on this body style. Would I have the stainless trim? Maybe, maybe not, if I wanted to slam it down a little bit lower. Everybody has their own personal choice, and that's what makes the hobby fun. Everything is going to be different, like Harley Davidson's. You can have a line of 100 Sportsters, every one of them will be different.
That's right.
And that's what makes it cool.
That's exactly what it is.
There's too many people out there that will be like, oh, your handlebars suck. Well, your freaking handlebars suck.
Exactly.
Doesn't matter. Like, I like those. They look good. They fit.
That's it. So the point is, too, ladies and gentlemen,
enjoy
get in this stuff to enjoy it. Don't be negative. Don't gossip. Don't talk, man. You know, just be cool about stuff. If you don't have anything positive to say, what good does being negative do, man? Does it make something? Does it make your car any better? Does it make your car better? There's an old saying I learned in psychology and for my in my undergraduate school. It was, you can't make yourself look big by making others look small, Bob. And you don't. You don't tear at somebody's pride and because you don't.
If your work is good, just let it sit and show. It will show.
Exactly.
If it sucks, it will show.
Because I bet you everything that everybody's got something negative to say about somebody else, I can go find something negative to say about them. But I choose to look at the positive side. One of the things this is in here for, this got a great big 454 DM crate motor, and the client didn't like the performance of the motor. I heard it run for the first time today when you fired it off, and it doesn't sound right, Bob. And if he's saying he can't turn his tires over, there's a problem.
Yeah. I mean, definitely, especially.
So, what happens? What causes these things?
So in cases like this, and it, you know, you don't really want to judge. Again, you don't want to judge the builders that built this truck, because this is a very solid truck. The underneath of this truck is just as clean as the top side. It's a beautifully built truck. Everything on the truck works, and that you really don't see that
too
often.
That's good, man. That's
everything
good.
Works. It runs, it drives, it does everything it should do. However, it's very sluggish on its performance. So that was one of the main reasons the client sent it straight into us. He had already driven it. He felt it was very, very sloppy for what it was. That not hard to argue with. You get in, you start the truck, it's sluggish on starting, feels weak, idles really rough, and it just doesn't have the power and performance that a performance 454 big block should have. That should be a good 400 plus horsepower on a rear wheel drive truck with a posi rear end. This is a bed. There's nothing more than 800 pounds sitting here, total weight between the bed, the framing, the suspension, everything. So realistically, anything over 350 horse in this truck should spin this thing sideways up the street, especially combined with a 4L60/700R4 transmission. Same thing, different names depending on the year. This thing should have a screaming first gear and just light the tires all the way up first, maybe through second, a touch into third, depending on how much these things will hook up.
And you'll get that all taken care of.
Oh, yeah.
You've certainly looked at it and identified what issues are out there.
Yep.
That's not a knock or a discredit to the builder.
Yeah.
Sometimes they get rushed to get them out to the auction block
but
there's a lot of good stuff.
That's what happens too. You know, you get a lot of these things where you get, and trust me, these things take a long time. I mean, ours takes.
This isn't a 2 month build, ladies.
We just finished the Moke, and that's a little golf cart. That took almost 12 months, 14 months.
Took more than that. Took about 18 months.
Yeah, for a little tiny Moke to get the steel panels fabricated, to get the body lifted where it's got to sit, to get everything adjusted right, to get. I mean, there's nothing there. There's no doors.
And you get into some of these bigger projects, and they could take 3-4 years to get them wrapped
up. Yeah, and that's not unheard of. It happens all the time. The stuff that, you know, in today's media, what people see on TV is not reality. It is the TV shows that are built to make something look like you can just do a complete restoration in 4 weeks, 3 weeks. It doesn't happen. It doesn't matter if I put 100 guys on something.
It just doesn't happen.
You won't get quality, no matter how fast you rush it.
The more people you have on a vehicle,
the
worse it's gonna be.
Yeah. If you have one guy that's working the entire body in terms of steel work, getting it ready to go, that one hand will touch every facet of that body. All the way around, from the inside of this bed lip all the way down to below the rocker panels. If you put three guys on it, you've got one guy working the top, one guy working the middle, one working the bottom. Then you never know, truly, are they overlapping? Are they working together? Does it ever even get done all the way?
So that's a lesson to learn, ladies and gentlemen. You can always throw more at it, more robots, more manpower, but if you want to slow it down, that's why roll work is expensive.
Right.
That's why Rolls Royces are expensive to build. That's why Porsches are expensive to build.
Mm-hmm.
People touch the cars and they take great pride in their quality of work.
That's a good point too. You know, when you even talk about, not even in a custom line of work, when you talk about today's real world
production
vehicles, General Motors, Ford, Mopar, all of the companies out there, if you guys have ever bought custom ordered cars, which I'm sure a lot of people out there have, they take 6 to 12, 14 months custom ordered.
For a Mercedes, we own a
Ford. Mercedes, for Bentleys, for Rolls Royce. These are cars that are already on robots, dropping down,
being mass produced,
coming down the assembly line, coming down, just dropping down and coming down. But if you put in there, you want white stitching in the seats, which you can do. You can do custom orders like that on Corvettes, on Challengers, on any of the Hellcats. You can do all of that stuff. You can ask for different wheels. All of that stuff takes time, and they will literally move you from a car that comes down the production, comes off, and is ready in a week, to a car that comes down, comes off, and is ready in 14 months, depending on the number of orders. It's just the way it goes. I mean, in doing mass production stuff that takes a long time, you better freaking rest assured that guys like us that do complete builds, it's going to take time to do it right.
It does take time, right? Yep. And a lot of people don't understand that, and they get itchy about it, and they don't want to sit down and wait.
Yep.
And those are the first people that are about badmouth you, because they don't understand. But they're not the ones going home with hands are hurt, backs are hurt, the thought processes. You're making 200 decisions an hour. If you make three of them correct, that's a pretty good odd, man. And you're on it about 99.9% of the time. So you have to know what you're doing, and you have to know your trade, and you have to bring forth a lot of quality, and that doesn't come cheaply, ladies and gentlemen. Mm-hmm. If you're having cars built to this level, like we do here, let your guys do it and be patient.
Yeah, it takes time to do it right. It truly does.
It does.
It doesn't matter. Even if you are getting a freaking engagement ring built, how long do those take? I've ordered one before. It took 7 months, and all they were doing was setting the thing.
You
just sizing it.
It took you 8 weeks. Layla, your fiance's ring, and it was built by a very reputable shop.
Beautiful,
big 4-carat ring. And the next thing you know, one of the settings was off in it, and it took 8 weeks for them to fix it.
Just to adjust it. It takes time to do it right, and that's this big, dude.
That's right.
That's a 4.5, that's it. Are you kidding me? Like, that? It takes that long to do something that small?
Yeah.
Do one small rust repair that size.
Exactly. It takes time. What's it take to cut the metal? What's it take to body work? What's
it just
take
takes
to
get
the style lining?
Just 5 minutes or so.
People don't see the style lines in the fenders and things like that. It takes time.
Yeah.
Okay? I guarantee you this was not a rust-free truck all its life.
No. This is, but it's a very, very solid truck now. That's what makes this so fun. And this is what I really love enjoy doing right here is, stuff like this that, these are the caliber of vehicles that we build, which is great. Here at Bubba's, this is exactly how we build stuff. And we're just going to take this thing and do a lot of fine tuning to it and get it exactly where the client wants in terms of the way the audio sounds, in terms of the performance of the engine, the way it looks under the engine compartment. Just spruce it up a little bit and get it exactly what he wants before it ships back up to Canada. He's going to love it.
I'll tell you what, you talk about a truck that'll spin the tires.
This thing will be sideways all the way up the street.
We don't do that to clients' vehicles, not even if they ask us to, but he'll be able to do it.
Yeah,
That's for sure.
This is literally sitting on intro wheels. These are custom order wheels. Intros are not coming off a shelf. These are high polished billet aluminum wheels that get custom cut. I mean, personally, me, I would have stuffed this hoe up. I mean, you've got another 4 inches
of more wheel under too, yeah.
That you could drop under this thing to get this out to that body line. I can set my stance pretty tight. Okay. You are here. I mean, if Matt, can you get a depth from my hand to this fender lip? It's probably 3.5, maybe 4 inches from this 12 o'clock fender lip out to here. If this thing were, from a suspension standpoint, this
like
truck
a mini
is tight, this would be, I mean, you have 13 and a half inches of meat back here. That's more than a Z06 or a ZL1. That's pretty freaking fat in the rear of this thing, but that's what I would have done.
Did we give you a mini tub look?
Do a stretch, man. This thing would be right.
Really, really good. Well, take us into tomorrow a little bit. Tomorrow is Friday. We do our weekend review from the broadcast studios here at Bubba's Exotic Motorsports, which is also where we host the number one rated internationally syndicated motorsports podcast in the world, doing it Bubba style, as heard on the Bubba Motorsports Network.
Yeah.
And that takes place Saturday mornings from 9 to 10 Eastern Standard Time. And the hotline is open for you guys to call in and enjoy it with us.
Well, there it is. I feel like you just took us into tomorrow, so much for me.
That was Saturday. Take us into tomorrow.
Oh, yes, tomorrow. Okay. Tomorrow I'm going to be, what am I going to do tomorrow?
And that's it for tomorrow's schedule, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, I guess that's about all I'm doing tomorrow.
That's...
Tomorrow I've got a lot of administrative stuff I'm doing today. I'm doing the final touches on the write-up of this truck, inside, outside, interior, exterior, because we break things down in three departments here. We do the exterior of the truck, what you see, which this truck is in beautiful condition. However, the lens on the other side, very small. The lens on the other side, the stainless trim is missing from it, so our people over at Eckler's, we can actually get another one sent right in, so that's exactly what we're going to do. So I'm just doing, exterior, then I move into interior, any situation there, and then also all the way down to mechanical. So you have looks, function, and you have the way it drives and runs, all things that you want.
That's it. We break it down into three modules: interior, exterior, mechanical. That's how we do it here. You know, the Robertsons, having just left here, are sitting there going, geez, I know exactly where they're standing in there. I know exactly how that's set up in there. I know the magic of all the studio equipment and the lighting in the background. I know the producer out there who's yelling at me.
That's
going
to throw his phone,
yeah,
for some reason.
That's exactly right. By the way, good video with you and the producer yesterday in the moat. I found it particularly funny when the producer said, I'm 6'1 and there's plenty of leg room. And then you go, and then you said, yeah, but I'm a little thicker than that. And he goes, yeah, I didn't say anything about shoulder room. You know, so.
Hey, you know, and that thing was fun too. If you guys didn't see it, if you're watching now, go to our, you can actually just hit our website. Go straight to bubbasexoticmotorsports.com. Scroll down, you'll see the YouTube links to it. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, man. If you guys enjoy what we do here, Bubba's, if you enjoy our tech tips, any of it, subscribe to our YouTube channel. It will literally, like, while we're standing here, it will hit your phone. I got a hit to my phone from us doing this. It automatically will notify you on the spot, wherever you are, in the plane, in the car.
Yep.
I mean, you got a cell service in a plane, but still, I pay for that Wi-Fi stuff.
There you go. I know you do.
So, you know, it'll go straight to your phone. So wherever you are, you'll never miss out on the action. If you do, go out to our YouTube channel and just look at all of the fun video. I, for the first time the other night, just sat down after a month of not getting on it, seeing it. I literally watched our YouTube videos for almost 2 hours, just laughing, having a good time. It was a really cool time. I mean, everything out there we do, not only personal interaction, but a lot of do-it-yourself advice. We do professional tech tips, all kinds of stuff you can imagine, and every video is something different.
And we do this for you guys, ladies and gentlemen. We're the only ones in the world who do this. We do it for you. We love our fans. We love our audience base out there, and we want you to feel very connected to us, and that's why we bring you a very personal feel. Bub Food Trucks tomorrow night at Miss Outlaw Boutique, msoutlawboutique.com, 561-660-6695. Ms. Outlaw is your official Monkey in Paradise
and
distributor from the Abacoa area.
Did you see, for any of you females out there watching, if you're in the area and you are local, this is a limited slot setup. She just, as of yesterday, launched a complete promotional setup she's doing. A full yoga class.
I saw that.
Right? Sponsored by, she literally had sponsors come in. Bole is sponsoring it, which is the most healthy place you could possibly.
Bole!
No, it's not like that. It's just Bole. And Crux Coffee, which is in downtown Abacoa. That is like literally coming up. You know how like the great white shark comes up and just sneaks up on you, and before you know it, it's over? Okay, that's what's happening. Like, here's Starbucks, here comes Crux. It's coming.
It's coming.
It's coming. I'm telling you, it's going to.
It's gonna happen.
It's gonna happen.
It's gonna happen.
It's just that simple.
So check it out, ladies and gentlemen. I know there's a possibility, although I'm trying to steer away from this.
Why would you say possibility?
Okay, we're gonna be down at Abaco at Jumbie Bay. My best friend, Mark Brown, the Marlins clubhouse manager. I'm gonna see him for the first time, ladies and gentlemen. I'm telling you, it gives me goosebumps.
Oh boy.
In 90 days.
I'll get
He's
out.
Very busy with spring training with the Marlins and the Cardinals. It's my time of year. I don't get to see him. It's almost like I'm going through a bad divorce kind of thing.
It is, but it's not costing you any money, so that's okay.
It doesn't cost me any money.
Nothing at all.
But
except for the fact that we always total each other's cars.
Exactly. So it's going to be a very interesting two nights being up at Jumbie tonight and tomorrow, because, ladies and gentlemen, the monkeys have also invaded Jumbie Bay.
They have.
You will soon be able to get your
monkey. I'm pretty sure.
At Jumbie Bay.
I'm pretty sure, and I really hope MIP covers my back on this one. If you are local, get your MIP tomorrow at Jumbie Bay.
Right on, because tomorrow is going to be
covered.
A big, big night. In fact, I better call Max and everything today and make sure that's in play.
I did last night, so that's what I'm saying.
I'm just a sponsor. I work for those guys. They're the best. I'm proud to be working for them, but you know what? It'd be nice if Monkey made an appearance out there tomorrow night.
I think it's already going to happen.
Okay, that sounds real good. Does Miss Outlaw at MissOutlawBoutique.com, does she have Monkey in Paradise in her shop for tomorrow night? I better make sure we've got that tomorrow night.
No, she does not.
I better finalize that tomorrow night. Okay.
And for all of the contestants out there, keep in mind you must be 21 or older, not to enter, but to win.
To
if
win.
If you want to have the cocktail markers, we have no problem sending them to you. Whatever you do on your time is what you do on your time, but in order for a bottle to leave our facility, it has to be authorized and approved. You are 21 and older.
That's right, correct. And I want to take a moment to remind you that Monkey in Paradise does ask us to remind everybody, please be social. That's what this is all about. They want to know what your paradise is, and they want you to be very social out there, but they do not want you drinking and driving, operating a motor vehicle, a boat, motorcycle, any of it, if you've had more than a drink. That's it.
Why'd you say boat right there?
Because
I feel like you were trying to hint at something.
The monkeys were on the boat last weekend, and it wound up on the shoreline because somebody had a few too many monkeys.
Can we talk? No, let's just not. Can we just move past it?
Hashtag Captain Tom, ladies and gentlemen.
No, hashtag you were not there.
Hashtag see, I'm not the only one who destroys it.
We almost like hashtag Titanic. Let's leave it at that.
Our producer shaking his head. No, was he in the front of the boat?
We were deep underwater. No, we were having a conversation.
I heard he was nose like was under and the prop was sticking up like
you
this.
You have no idea. Like we were standing there, and you know how I am. No panic mode. Not at all. I was just like, as I'm driving, like hand on the throttle, I was like, yo, Matt, we are taking on water fast. And he was like, well, what's causing that? And before you know it, we were like 4 feet going in, nose in, pontoon boat, like hashtag sunken boat at the dock.
Hashtag Bubba the Submarine.
Hashtag Captain Bub.
Hashtag Captain
That's where
Bub.
It was at.
Mr. Producer, did you have some questions today, sir, before we get out of here?
Nothing.
Michael McCloskey just wants you to put all those positive vibes in his build.
It's going. You see this color on this truck? It's pretty close.
This guy over here, huh?
Pretty close.
Pretty close. That's all I'm going to say. That's all I'm going to
yep.
say. That's it. All I'm going to say. We don't need to say much more than that, brother. What else you got over there, Mr. Producer? Did we hear from Joe Kramer today?
Yeah, he wants to know what the bare frame is for.
What the bare frame?
Ah, okay. Okay, so to your right is a 1953 Chevrolet C3100. This truck is super cool. It's been in our facility for about 12 months. We're doing a crazy, crazy build on this thing. However, it is not going to be a show quality job. This is going to be a build that is 100% modern setup, front to rear. So it's going to be a serpentine belt system. It's going to be a small block Chevrolet 350 hooked to a Turbohydro 700 R4 transmission, which is going to be a 4-speed automatic, going to a GM 10 bolt rear. So it's going to be a very nice, I'd say equivalent to like a mid-90s Corvette drivetrain underneath of this truck. However, the client wants it to look exactly as it does because his dad bought this truck in 53 brand new. So he wants it to be the very raw, rough, old and vintage looking setup. He doesn't want crazy wheels on it like this, just a traditional steely wheel looking really fat in the back. We are gonna put some meat under it, but we're gonna do it on a steely wheel so it looks original, but it's got all of today's features and drivetrain to it. So when you open the hood, it is just going to be a nice matte black texture with a gloss orange Chevrolet small block in it, exactly the way GM would have done it if they built that truck in 53 with a Chevrolet 350.
And Bub, that's gonna be a really exciting build.
Yep.
It's gonna be another something like this kind of thing.
Yep.
It's gonna be an exciting build. Make sure you make plans to join us with the Robertsons here around the 5th of May.
I'm not gonna be here.
As we demonstrate the new Nano USA product. It's gonna be pretty cool. Or join us at Cars and Coffee and see that with Max and Seth and Alex and the whole crew from Monkeys out there. But we're gonna get ready to jump out of here. We got a lot to do this afternoon. Ladies and gentlemen, we ran a little bit over. We went on a little bit late, but I missed you guys. I really, really did. It's hard when I'm not with you for 2 days. I really take this personally. I know Bub takes it very personally. You guys mean the world to us out there, and you come to us everywhere from Glasgow, Scotland, to Huntington Beach, California. Fenway Park to Abilene, Texas out there. Richard, you know we're talking to you. We can't thank you enough. It gives me chills. It really, really does. And I'm very thankful that you guys are part of the Bubba's Motorsports family. And I'm thank you. We allow you into your living rooms and into your homes and into your hearts, man.
Just that simple.
So it's a heartfelt thing. We care about our fans and everything like that. But
yeah, so that's it. So stay tuned till tomorrow. We'll give you guys another update in the shop. We're actually going to be detailing the moat, the 77.com/Bubba's Exotic Motorsports. You'll see that car in its entirety. It's finished, it's detailed, it's done, it's ready to go. Client's getting ready to pick it up this afternoon. I'll continue on this one, and we'll bring you something live tomorrow.
I do have a video that's getting ready to go up as well.
The
producer went out on a test drive, so it's pretty cool stuff. So, ladies and gentlemen, again, I apologize for being on the road for 2 days. You know, when you have contractual obligations, you got to fulfill them with fans. You just got to do what you got to do. But we're happy to be in your hearts. We're happy to be in your homes. Thanks for allowing us very much to be part of your family, Bub. Till tomorrow,
just keep on doing it, Bubba style.
And please make sure you step out today to touch somebody's life in a positive manner. If somebody's hungry,
can I have this for tomorrow?
If somebody's hungry, make sure you feed them. If somebody needs a door open, for God's sakes, help an elder. If somebody needs shoes on their feet, Payless is cheap. If somebody needs a food, McDonald's is cheap. Until tomorrow, just keep on doing it, Bubba style. Hey, Bub, what do you want to do right now? Hit that bottle?